But I would ask Hans to share his screen and kind of set the baseline from an architectural perspective, so we'll understand exactly kind of what we're talking about and then maybe what the opportunity is. Go ahead, Hans.
Thanks, Brian. So I have only a couple of slides to introduce the topic. So here I have in total two different, slightly different topologies for OTT delivery over satellite. One is starting from the traditional video world and one is starting from an IP satellite network. So on this screen here, the topology shows how traditional video service providers like DTH operators can enrich the delivery without having to change the entire set-top box base from day one. The top left shows the traditional video playout, so whereby finally the transport stream is transmitted over satellite as specified by DVB, and that stream is received by a DTH set-top box, and mainly TV screens were the target of that transmission.
So Hans, pause right there 1 second. What's new in this slide? What's new and different in this slide?
What is different is the bottom left. So that is where we add the OTT content. So the bottom left shows that the addition. So you can see that it's a traditional OTT playout comprising of the origin, etc. But then you stream in unicast. And before we go on satellite, we're going to multicast that traffic so that we can do efficient transmission over satellite. So we still use the same modulator, but we are going to encapsulate that multicasted ABR format in the MPEG transport stream. And that is all still via the DVB standard, the traditional DVB standard, so that at the remote site, you can add a low-cost set-top box, or you can replace the set-top box of those people that want to receive that service. And there we are going to do the opposite, convert again to the multicast to unicast. And then there is a whole lot of functionalities on that set-top box that can help bring that content to life for live streaming. But it's also possible to do on-demand content by smart pre-positioning content on that box if it has storage. So that is for the customers that for the service providers that come from the traditional video world. So the new part is here how we interface this traditional OTT playout in such a way that transmission over satellite becomes efficient and effective. Mm-hmm. Then here you can see a slightly different topology. So here we start from an IP satellite network. So not the traditional style, but an IP satellite network. So rather than introducing here the multicasted ABR content into a traditional modulator, it's now going to be provided to a VSAT platform. A VSAT platform basically sets up an IP pipe over satellite between a central location, as you can see here, and remote points of presence. So the format on satellite is now GSC encapsulation coming from the data world, but that is also being standardized by DVB as we speak, and it will be it is called now native IP. So in this case, the remote terminals can range from a consumer VSAT modem to very performant high bitrate modems that you would need possibly on cruise ships that have a lot of data transmission in general going back and forth. But also we can add a low-cost receive-only set-top box that can pick up the same carrier and data stream. And we have EKT here also in the panel that has built such a set-top box. So also here on top of the live video and the smart pre-positioning of content can be done. We distribute it then also here to the edge so that we can support on-demand video models from all these different types of use cases, as you can see here. We have one partner that does this today who provides Netflix content to ships, for example. So that's coming from the IP satellite world. And then if you look at the different use cases, they both originate as discussed in the traditional world, but also coming from the IP satellite world. So the top left corner, we have the traditional DTH as shown in the topology. That is how we can distribute OTT content, helping to migrate those service providers to provide also OTT content. Then another one here important is distance and remote learning. So here we are going to address homes, but also schools, for example, or other communities in these COVID times. Then there is telco video, that's about optimizing video over existing cellular backhaul networks. We have in-flight and maritime entertainment, crew morale and welfare. We can also help CDN streamers expand the footprint where it is not possible to build terrestrial backbones with enough bitrate. And of course, we can also help ISP providers, broadband access providers, and we can provide also enterprise video. So I will come back to those use cases. So what does this now mean? So we can help satellite service providers to achieve several goals here. We can help them to expand the service footprint. Satellite always has been able to scale rapidly and cost effectively. And you have the network already up in the sky, and it's about putting down receivers, which can be done very fast. Improve the quality of experience for live and on-demand. So satellite allows to possibly put edge servers with a finer granularity into the field, which can help provide the quality of experience for mass events. And for on-demand, we can also provide good quality of experience because of the smart pre-positioning of content at the edge storage. And I'll show you later on, we can talk about how this can be done also on the VSAT network. There is a choice of service bundles that with match terminals. So we discussed already the low-cost set-top box that can be a receiver, but all the way up to a very performant VSAT modem with very high bit rates. In case there is no return link, also satellite can provide that so that you can do DRM, CDN analytics, and all the other applications that you can run on a bidirectional IP network. This is, of course, not satellite versus terrestrial, but it's rather a promotion to have a hybrid network so that you can play with the advantages that satellite brings to the table, which is offloading of congested backbones, but it can also help with improving the resilience in the case of disasters. So that's a quick overview of how we see the topology, the advantages, and then the different use cases, which span a large spectrum, I would say.